Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you some tips for using the list view in the Finder. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So list view in the Finder is probably the view with the most functionality. You can get to list view by either clicking here on this button, which will change to list view, or going to view as list. List view gives you not only the names of the files, but also other information about each one. So for instance, here you can see the date modified, the size, and the kind of each file. List view also allows you to easily sort the files in a variety of different ways. So basically you can use the column title to sort them. In this case, they're already sorted by name in ascending order. And you can see here this little mark, this arrow pointing up, tells you it's using this column name and doing it in ascending order. If I wanted to sort by date modified, all I need to do is click the date modified title and you can see the arrow moves there. Now they're sorted by date modified in ascending order. You can always reverse the order of the sort by clicking again and you can see that arrow now is pointing down. And now we have the most recent files first. The same thing here with name. We click that once and we're in alphabetical order starting with A. But if we click again, you can see now it reverses the order and it goes from Z to A. Now you can resize any of these columns by clicking and dragging the line between the titles. And you can see that the cursor changes there. I can click and drag to the left or right to resize the column. Notice if you do that with columns that have dates in them, the format of the date will change. So as I shrink this, you can see it goes to a smaller format. And when I enlarge it, it goes to a larger format spelling out the whole month. You could also double click on any of these little lines to right size the column. In other words, it'll match the longest piece of text there. So it was able to shrink this name column because there was excess space. If I shrink this column too much, you can see the names are shortened. I can move my cursor over one and wait and I could see the file name appear. But I could also just double click and it will right size it again, making it larger to fit the longest name there. Now you could add many more columns than just these four. There are two ways to do that. One really simple way is to control click on any of these titles here. Just hold the control key down, click, and you get this little list here and you'll see the check marks next to the columns that are there. By default, name is always there as a column, but I have these three additional columns here. I could add a new one, like let's add date created, and now you can see I have that new column there. I can control click and remove date created just as easily. You could also go to view and then show view options or just command J, and here you'll see a list of all of the different columns and you can check or uncheck each one. Now you can also rearrange the columns. So if you want size to be to the left of date modified, just click and drag and you can move that column around. You can't put anything to the left of the name column, but you can move the rest of the columns to be in any order you want. Now when we looked at the view options there with command J, we saw that there's also two sizing options. You can change the size of the text, make it larger, or even go smaller. And you also have two choices in icon size. So you make the icon a little bit bigger, which will make it easier to see some of the picture icons there. Now if you're sorting by size, one of the things that you may notice is the folders don't have size. They just have two dashes there. But if you want to include folders in that sort, you need to enable Calculate All Sizes here in the View options. When you do that, the folder sizes will be shown as well. Now it's pretty quick here. There's not too much in these folders. But if the folders have lots of files in them, it may take several seconds or even minutes for all the folder sizes to be filled in and complete. Now you may also notice here that under Dates you get dates like yesterday. If you'd rather not see those, you can turn off Use Relative Dates. It actually switches to showing dates for everything rather than using labels like today or yesterday. Now, if you want to dig down into folders using List View, there's really interesting functionality. You have these little reveal triangles here to the left of any folder. If you click on one, it expands to show you the files in there. And you could view the files in this folder as well as all the rest of the files at this level. You can expand as many of these folders as you want. Now notice it does it with an animation. You could see the expansion. That could actually take a little while if you have a longer folder. You can shorten that time by holding the Option key. Watch what happens when I do it normally. And watch what happens when I do it holding the Option key down. Now you can also open folders using the keyboard. So if I click and select this folder, I can use the up and down arrows to navigate up and down in the list. But if I use the right arrow, it expands the folder. The left arrow will shrink it back into the folder. Cool thing about that is you can do it with multiple folders. So I can use the Command key here and click this folder, and now I have two folders selected. If I use the right arrow key, both of those folders open up. Left arrow, both of those folders will close. Now if I do Command A, it selects everything. And if I do right arrow, it will expand all of those folders. And you can see I still have just the folders selected that are at that top level. Now notice there are some other folders here. If I do Command A again, now it selects everything that's visible, and the right arrow will expand any folders that are there. And I can use left arrow and everything shrinks back. So you can navigate around here with the keyboard. So I can move up and down. I can move right to go into a folder. I can move down through there. And I can use copy and paste or copy and move to move a file. So for instance, I can go in here and say I want to move this file. I'll do Command C to copy. Nothing happens right away. I can go up here, left arrow to close that, go down to this folder, right arrow to open this. And if I do Command V, I would paste a copy in here. You can see here Command V, paste item. But if I hold the Option key down, you can see Option Command V is move item here. So Option Command V, and that item moves into that folder. So you can navigate around and move files using just the keyboard. You can also use Command Z to undo a move like that. Now you can also do that using the mouse in spring-loaded folders. So if I open this folder up here and I grab a file like this and I move it over images and I wait, images will open up. I'll go down into it and I can drop that file into there. You can see now it's taken me down into that folder. If you want to get up out of it, you can use Command Up Arrow and you go back up a level. Now you can use grouping here instead of sorting just everything alphabetically together. So you can go to View and Use Groups, and when I do that you can see View Sort By changes to View Group By, and I can change the group. So I have Kind here, but I can also do Date Last Opened, and I can see it puts them all in groups. You can also click here and change the grouping as well. Another type of grouping is to have folders on top all the time. So in order to do that you have to set the grouping to none and you have to be sorted by name. Then you can go into Finder Preferences and keep folders on top in Windows when sorting by name, and all of the folders will be at the top before all of the files. Now in Column View you usually see a preview of the file that's selected on the right. You can do that in List View as well, although it's not on by default. If you go to View and you use Show Preview, you get that same preview area here to the right. So you still have all the functionality here of List View, but with the preview area that includes extra information about the file and also Finder Quick Actions. I could see an image, I could see PDF, I could see text files, all sorts of things. Now here's a really bizarre trick. You can control click here, I showed you, to select different columns that could appear. But there are some special hidden columns you could bring up. In order to do that you have to have the folder named a certain thing. For this folder of images, let's change the name. I'm just going to hit return and change the name and change it to pictures. That's a special name. Now when I go into this folder here, I see it in List View, and if I control click here, in addition to all the standard columns, I could add dimensions and resolution, and you can see those appear here on the right. Let's shrink down the name column so we can see them all together. Now you can see the dimensions and resolutions of these images, and you could even sort by them. So that only works if the folder happens to have the exact name pictures. So if you're creating a project folder and you're putting a bunch of images into a folder inside of that, you may want to think about naming it pictures just to use this functionality. Or name it whatever you want, like I had it as images, but simply change the name to pictures in order to see these extra columns. And then when you go back into it, even though you've changed the name, you'll see dimensions and resolution stay there as columns. Now if you rename a folder movies, that's also a special name. When I go into that, if I control click, I see in addition to the normal columns, dimensions, duration, title, and codecs. So I can add these columns to folders that are named movies. And one last thing I want to show you is that when you go to open and save dialog boxes inside of apps, in this case I'm in pages here and I'm going to open a new file, by default you're going to see column view. But you can click here and go to list view, and then you've got full list view here, including the ability to sort and control click and add and remove columns inside of open and save dialogs in apps on your Mac. So even if you prefer to use column view or icon view as your main view, it's worthwhile to learn how to use list view because it has a lot of utility in being able to see things like dates, sizes, kinds of files all here in the list, and then easily sort by any one of those and helps you organize and work with your folders and files. Also, whenever you do a find, so I'm going to search here for something, you're going to get a list view as the result here. So knowing how to control the columns and sorting is important. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.